Hello, my dear viewer, today we're going to talk about the talent management. This is a second lectures for learning and talent development. First, we're going to look at what is the talent management. We're going to look at the definition. Secondly, we're going to move on the strategy. And lastly, we're going to look at the process of the talent management. The concept of the talent management is to ensure that the organization has talented people to meet its business needs. Talented employees possess special gifts, qualities, and aptitude which enable them to perform their jobs effectively. Talent management covers the process: attractions, identification, deployment, development, engagement, motivation, and retention. Let us take a look at the definition of the talent management. Talent management is the systematic process of attraction, identification, deployment, development, and retention of those individuals with high potentials and who are creating value to the organizations. High potentials. Let us take a look at the second definitions. In the second definition, talent management is an integrated set of processes, activities, programs, and cultural norms in an organization's designed and implemented to attract, engage, and retain talent to achieve strategic objectives and meet future business need. That the same definitions, but focusing not high potential. Here the focus is only to the talent, and focus is to achieve the strategic objective currently and in the future. Let us take a look at the other definition: a set of organization processes designed to ensure effective flow of human resources, including leadership resources. So the talent management, CIPD stated, talent management consists of those individuals who make difference in the organizations. These difference they could make through immediate contribution or through long term by demonstrating their high potentials. So this is focusing on the high potentials, and there are other school of thoughts. They are saying all the employees who are in the organizations contributing to the success of the organization. Let us take a look of some graphical representations. Inclusive and exclusive. Inclusive. First, let us take a look on the exclusive. Exclusive part, that is on the top two quadrant on the horizontal side, focusing exclusive. That is a process that is focusing on the high flyer, high potentials, leaders, and professionals. Whereas the lower quadrant, they are focusing all the employees who are working in the organizations. They are directly or indirectly contributing to the success of the organization. When we're going to look on the broad view, it is covering all the processes that we mentioned: identification, attraction, development, motivation, and retention cover all the processes. Narrow view states that only succession planning and human resource planning are the two parts that is covering the talent management. This is the view. However, it is a blended approach. CIPD stated there is no specific rule, there is no specific agreement. Talent management is a blended approach. Could be inclusive, could be exclusive. Let us take a look at another. This one is the Steward and Riggs stated, talent management is individual focus, the upper two quadrant, and then the lower two quadrant is organization focus. If you're gonna perform the activities, these two activities, that will create scarce resources. If you're gonna take action on these activities, that is L&D and HR processes to maximize everyone's potential, ensure right people in the right job, and this, that will create, that is plentiful resources, focusing all the employees. So now let us take a look on the war for talent. McKinsey and Company stated, the war, in order to win for that is to attract the high potentials, the managers who could make difference, you should have to go for the war. Let us take a look, what is the war for talent? There are five imperatives that have been stated by McKinsey and Company, stating that in order to win the war, you have to create a winning employee value proposition, build recruitment and selection process taking into account the strategy, and also use job experience, coaching and mentoring to cultivate potential in employees, to develop the employees, to nurture the potential in employees, and then the organization has to strengthen on talent pool by investing on player A, developing player B, and taking decisive action on player C. And lastly, it is a pervasive mindset, that is, organization is going to get the competitive advantage if the organization is having better talent at all levels. Let us take a look at some criticism. In the criticism, it is stated, if the organization is going for war for talent, then my dear knowledge workers, this mindset when raid outsiders and downplay the talent already in the organizations. Venerate means giving more respect to the outsiders join the organization, and do not give much attention to the insider are making the difference, and that you are going to create a culture that could lead you to the arrogance instead of attitude of wisdom, and it is going to create a hazard, and you are going to create an organization who could have success using the war for talent, but could not be good for the health of the organization and detrimental to achieve the success if you are going for the war in the long run. So talent management. Let us wrap up the definition, or let us encapsulate or sum up. The talent management is inclusive, talent management is exclusive, and it is agreed upon that as per the CIPD, it is a blended approach. Let us take a look on the type of talents. There is a leadership talents, developing the strategies, developing the visions, setting the long-term objectives, anticipating the environment. And there is a key talent. Key talent is the professionals have mastered in their subject, high potential, flyers, and core talent. Based on that, your business is established. Peripheral talent, peripheral talent is that if the post is vacant, like administration, that could not have a major impact on the organization. Let us take a look on the strategy of the talent management. First, let us see strategy. What is the strategy? Strategy is a plan of action designed to accomplish the long-term goal there are different definitions of the strategy, but we're going to take a look on that plan of action designed to accomplish the long-term goals. What are the, your plans? What are your actions you're going to take in order to retain, in order to motivate, in order to develop, in order to engage the employees? These are the interventions, these are the processes and the practices you are going to follow in order to accomplish your talent management strategy. What is that? First, what define what is talent management, or the talent mean in term of competencies and potentials? You're gonna see it that. And then define the future talent requirement plan. What is your future requirements? Define the develop the job descriptions. In short, that when you develop the job descriptions, have the opportunity employee could demonstrate multi-skillings, they could perform the job, that could give the challenge, variety of tasks should be there. And recruitment, while recruiting and selecting, ensure that there is a rigorous recruitment and selection, and ensure that you have the orientation and onboarding programs, employee value propositions in order to attract and retain. Look at the Silicon Valley's, the organizations, what they are going to use, the employee proposition, value proposition, providing the unique benefits that attract them, flexible, keep the work-life balance, maintain the equity. There are procedures, there are processes and procedures that for the promotions, for the training. So all these are the talent management strategies. The strategy means how you're going to retain, how you're going to attract. You're going to use the succession planning. So you have the potentials. You need to conduct the audit to ensure that who are the potential levers, who are your high potentials that you need to focus on to develop them. So corporate social responsibility, all the activities, all the tools and techniques, all the programs and the schemes, those are used in the organizations to attract, to motivate, and to satisfy the employees, are encompassing the talent management. This is a part of the talent management strategy. Let us take a look on the process. The process is the business strategy. You have the business strategy, then the resourcing strategy. Under the resourcing strategy, you have the internal resourcing and external resourcing. You gotta focus, develop the policies and procedures that could underpin your business strategy, that could attract, that could motivate the employees, that could create fairness and equity. Also, the design the role. While designing the role, ensure that there is challenging work, there is autonomy, there is opportunity the employees have to demonstrate their knowledge, skills and ability to realize their full potentials, the career development, succession planning, and lastly, the organization will have a talent pool in order to achieve the short term and the long-term, current and the future objectives. My dear knowledge workers, talent management is covering, means developing and maintaining the pool of talented peoples. All the time the organization should have the backup if the employees are leaving. That means you have the talent management pipeline all the time, it is full. So this is the talent management. Talent management consists of individuals, the peoples, whether using the inclusive or the exclusive, that could contribute to the organization. I fully support, my personal opinion is that all the employees who are in the organization, they contribute for the success of the organization directly or indirectly. But this is my opinions that I could give my opinions on that. And these are the videos related to the talent management, the first lectures on that, and the references, and lastly, we have developed the website. That website is still under construction, but all the videos till now we have developed, we have placed the videos here. You can visit on this website and go to the learning and talent development videos icon, and you're gonna find all the videos there. Thank you very much for watching this lecture. Very soon I will be back with the new lectures covering the strategic role of the learning and talent development for the organization's success. Thank you again. Bye.